16th of December, and yes, this time every Tuesday morning, we get a visit from one of our faves. It's Ron the Car Guy here this morning, talking about something very timely, especially this time of year. When people have something they can start their vehicle with.
You're under a lot of pressure.
And stand back and wait for it to warm up, Ron.
God, I hope I brought something that was timely. No, I was looking. There's no lights on the camera. I can't see them. I didn't know which camera to look at.
We don't pay attention to those things.
You know, talk. And
yeah, let's get Jeff in here. Fix this engineering feed. Okay,
no, we won't pay attention.
Yeah. We don't want Jeff in here.
What are we talking about this morning?
We're going to talk about key fobs, and we talked about these once before on the show, but this time of year, I get a lot of calls, I get a lot of questions, and a lot of people come in with issues, so I just want to talk a little bit about it. The key fob itself, and I think last time I was on, I think it was Jason said, what does the word fob mean?
We looked it up, I believe.
We did look it up, and do you remember what it means?
No. I have no short-term memory since I started working
since
these hours.
Since you work a morning show.
Fob actually came out of the 1800s. It was an ornament that was attached to pocket watches.
Well, that's right. That's right. Yeah.
And I don't know why we recycled that when we came out with cars in the 20th century, but that's where the word fob came from, which is irrelevant to what we're going to talk about this morning. But
I like decorations on my
Christmas time ornaments.
There we go. I brought it up. Yeah, I was planning. But no, fobs. This time of year, it's cold. People want to make sure that they can lock and unlock their car. They're carrying gifts out from the mall. And then you've also got, you know, a lot of the fobs now do the remote start function and stuff. And people come in and fobs don't work. And I just want to talk a little bit about that. Probably the most common issue you have with key fobs. I've got this one here. This is actually mine, so I hope I can make it work by the time I leave. But anyway, the case, it basically just pries apart. The most common problem we see in it is inside the fob.
Is a battery?
Is a battery. And that's the most common failure is the battery goes bad. So, and you'll see that because it takes a longer range to unlock the car. You got to be right next to it and stuff. But here's something that's interesting. Last Friday, we had a lady that was in. She had a Honda Odyssey van, and she said she was my key fob don't work. I think I need a new one.
Right.
And I was trying to help her out a little bit, and I said, well, you know, have you changed the battery? She goes, I put two batteries in it. It still doesn't work. And so I took it apart. The battery was in upside down.
But it was the right one?
Yeah, correct battery. I flipped it around, put it in, and then, of course, I looked like a hero, and I looked like Ron the Car Guy.
Yeah.
But that's something to keep in mind is on these batteries, there's usually a plus and a minus on each side. And then inside the fob case, there will be a plus. And so you just want to make sure that battery goes in correctly. And so I put her battery in correctly, and it worked just fine.
Because fobs can be expensive.
Oh yeah, yeah. They can be, you know, anywhere from about $40 to I've seen them over $300.
Jeez.
And that is something to keep in mind. Yeah. I mean, if you these happen to be Lou's keys here, and we're giving a plug for Carl Chevrolet this morning.
What a shocker!
Yeah, imagine that.
I got my car from him.
But Lou's got what I call the switchblade key, which pops up. And people think that, you know, if the fob part goes bad, they're going to have to buy this whole thing. This is a channel key. It's laser cut and stuff, and it could be very expensive. But typically, we can take this apart and reuse the key portion. You're just buying the fob part of it. Mm-hmm. So you know, never jump to a conclusion that, you know, you need the whole of something or something's going to be expensive. I mean, if you have a question, give us a call, but we can actually reuse the key blade part of it. Or if this breaks off, we can get just the key blade.
You don't need to buy the whole thing.
Correct. Okay. So that's something to kind of keep in mind. The other thing, and this is a common problem, and I see cars come in with all kinds of fixes for this, but you'll see where the ring goes through the little hoop on the key fob,
that breaks off.
Yeah, and I've seen duct tape, I've seen zip ties, Band-Aids, Gorilla Glue, all kinds of stuff holding it on there, and it's as simple as buying the case.
You
can buy just a case itself.
Right. My hauler, I broke the key. The hauler is exactly like this, and I broke the end off.
Yep, and what do you got, tape on it or something?
I don't even have it with it anymore. Yep. I just use the key.
Or I've seen people take the key and just tape the key to the back of that. No, for the popular ones, you can buy just a case.
And then you just
transfer the battery and the circuit board and put the new ring in it. So the cases are readily available to resolve that problem if you happen to run into it. So the first most common.
You can do something beside using a zip tie.
Exactly. Oh, exactly. And the case probably costs just a little bit more than the zip tie. Certainly less than duct tape. But and you don't have to replenish it all the time. But so the most common problem is a battery. We replace a lot of cases because that edge gets broke off, or I've seen the buttons wear through.
Mm-hmm. And the batteries, you don't necessarily have to go to a car specialty joint to get the batteries, because it seems like everybody has the little button batteries.
I think you can get them at Casey's now. Yeah. I mean, I know like Walgreens.
Like CR32s or something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think this is a 2025 that's in there, something like that. So, and then, of course, you know, you've got the other potential problems. This is actually a transmitter. It transmits a radio frequency, and there's actually a receiver in the car that receives that frequency, kind of like your garage door opener. Hmm. And so there is a potential of being issues with that. And that is easily tested with a tester. And basically we turn the tester on and we hit the key fob and we look at it. Yeah. If it's blinking, we know that this is sending a signal. Cool. And so we're good through here. The problem could be in the vehicle. And what we see sometimes, the European cars are kind of finicky, but we've seen it on some domestic vehicles, is for whatever reason, maybe a battery was changed or there was a problem in the electrical system that created a voltage issue or something like that, the car will just forget.
Really?
This is learned, just like we talked about the tire pressure sensors a while back, how they have to be trained and learned to the car. The car learns these fobs, and it'll just forget.
And what do you do about that then?
You go in, you reprogram the fob.
There's a series of maneuvers you have to go through?
Yeah, and some of them you can do it through the dash. I mean, you pull up fob training, you hold the fob button down or two buttons down or something for so many seconds. Some are a little more complex where you've got to have a factory scan tool, and you got to go into programming and program the computer and say, hey, I want you to learn the signal coming out of this fob right now. But there's, you know, there's multiple ways to do that, just depending on the vehicle. And I mean, if you've got one that needs to be retrained, I mean, give us a call. We can walk you through it, or stop by. We can certainly help you out with that.
All right, good to know. Good to know. So all good tips, especially with the weather getting the way it is now. People don't want to go out there and fiddle around, try to unlock the door, or even start their vehicle.
Like, well, yeah, because there's so many with remote start now. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's got a battery in it as well. Mm-hmm. So,
all right, good to know. So people want more information on this or questions in general. How do they get a hold of you?
Questions in general, they can go to AskRonTheCarGuy.com, or they can contact me through our website, which is WestsideAutoPros.com.
All right, wonderful. Great job as always. It is.